I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna let the reason out that his love goes on forever. I'm gonna take it all the way.
Welcome back to the Maple Minute this Thursday, November 17th, 2022. We've been talking about biblical building, biblical quality friendships, and we're going to look more into today into the friendship between Jonathan and David and the building blocks of friendship according to that. See, we can recognize over in 1 Samuel 18, we can recognize five distinct stages in Jonathan's friendship to David that helped secure this deep friendship they had. And these are principles that we should use to build quality relationships. So let's get into this today. Number one, we say an attitude of acceptance. I think the key to everything that follows is not something so much that Jonathan did as his attitude towards David. You remember his father Saul had an attitude of pride, and so he wanted to use people, and he did at times try to use people, but it didn't last. He had that angry spirit, and so he's always out trying to kill those that might be better than him. And that was the opposite of how Jonathan displayed. Jonathan had not a conditional acceptance, but an unlimited acceptance, just like Jesus teaches us. And that's the attitude we should have in our godly friendships. We should have this attitude of acceptance, accept people on the basis of who God created them to be, not on what they can do for us. Number two is mutual attraction. Now, 1 Samuel 18, verse 1, the verse tells us that after David had finished talking with Saul, Jonathan became one in spirit with David, and he loved him as himself. Now, I know there have been some people who have used this passage to say this was a homosexual relationship. It was not, definitely was not, because God does not condone homosexual relationships. He doesn't. In fact, the Bible declares it to be an abomination to him. But what we have to see here in this relationship is there was this mutual attraction. Jonathan felt drawn to David. Birds of a feather flock together is the old saying, right? And this friendship is first built on this mutual attraction, which is the character of the spirit of David attracted because David was a man after God's own heart. It attracted Jonathan. The problem with attraction that we have to notice is that if it's not built on the right basis, there can be a problem with it. See, we can be attracted to others because of what we lack, or on the basis of superficial love, and or what they can bring to the table for us. And that is a problem, because that's not really mutual attraction. That's I'm attracted to what I can get out of it. And that's how how Saul was acting. Jonathan didn't have a superficial love. He had a deep love because he saw the character of David being a man after God's own heart. And it went way beyond superficial attraction to a spiritual state. And that's where he really saw the character and integrity of him. Number three, the third building block is an expression of commitment. The third stage to Jonathan's friendship is commitment. He had the attitude that was expressed through his attraction, and now we see it in a covenant form. Verse number 3 of chapter 18 says that Jonathan made a covenant. Now, covenants were something you made between two people. They weren't contracts, they were covenants, and they were irrevocable, and they were done in the sight of God. So this is a solemn vow that he made a covenant with David because he loved him as himself. He was so drawn to him that he made this commitment to treat him just as good as he treats himself. And that's, you know, for each of us, we're our favorite person, aren't we? And so this is an expression of commitment. And so he went beyond just like, hey, let's hang out. Hey, let's be friends. Hey, let's share some things. He went and made a covenant commitment to him. And that took it to a whole nother level. Number four, we see genuine openness as a building block. Verse number four, the next verse, Jonathan took off the robe he was wearing. He wore his outer robe, his princely garments, and gave it to David along with his tunic and even his sword, his bow, and his belt. These are symbolic acts of providing for his friend. And it provides rich lessons. First, this was an act of honor. For the son of the king, to give you all those things was a show of honor. He respected David. Remember, David was that one who didn't come from affluence, he didn't come from wealth, he didn't come from any kind of high-level family, but David did have a lot of character, and so he's honoring him. Secondly, I think we see it's an act of elevation. Jonathan, when he gives him these things, he's trying to draw David up to his same status. He's saying, we're equals. I'm not above you as the prince. I'm not above you as the king's son. I'm not above you because I've got more money. We're equals, and so here, what's mine is yours, and that's a great thing. And then third, I think what you find here in this openness is that Jonathan is opening up his life, everything about himself. And so here, it's symbolic of, I'm giving you what is mine, and that's such a deep thing. Last of all, the fifth stage is that Jonathan showed an appreciative enjoyment of David. Verse 5, it says, whatever mission Saul sent him on, David was so successful that Saul gave him high rank in the army. Now, if you just sort of read this and don't understand what's going on or haven't really paid attention, you're thinking, well, he just got a promotion. What's the big deal? The real truth is David was given the rank that Jonathan used to have. Remember, Jonathan back in chapter 14 was leading the attack, and he was doing all these things. And Saul, since David's been doing so well, Saul gives this to David. So who should be jealous? Should be Jonathan, right? But it didn't. In fact, it says this pleased all the troops and Saul's officers as well. The high rank that Saul gave to David was Jonathan's at one time. And Jonathan enjoyed, he didn't get upset, he didn't get envious, he didn't get angry. He enjoyed David's promotion, his exaltation. He wasn't threatened by David because he knew that the future, that his future and David's future, they were all in God's hands, and that was so great. So he could relax in the stability of this friendship, and that's what was an enjoyment. When you can sit back and you can be happy for people who are your friends that are getting things that maybe you didn't get or thought you should get, that's great. See, here's the bottom line for this. Friendship involves a confidence in the other person that is very giving, but also undemanding. And so often we see in today's 21st century relationships demanding friendships. I don't know what kind of friendships you have, but friendship is to be enjoyed and not endlessly analyzed. Jonathan was careful to give David some breathing room to do what he needed to do. And Jonathan built a quality friendship because he was concerned about meeting David's needs, not David meeting his needs. He wasn't trying to use David to fill himself. And that led to this acceptance, this attraction, this commitment, this openness, and this enjoyment, the five things that we just talked about. Those are the building blocks of a solid friendship. So let's ask some questions to think it over. In the five building blocks of friendship, that is acceptance, attraction, commitment, openness, and enjoyment that Jonathan and David shared, which one stood out most to you and why? Secondly, what are the key foundations for your friendships? What makes them so important? Maybe you've never thought about this, but maybe you have to sit down and say, why is this person my friend? What have we built our friendship on? And then thirdly, and last of all, how are demanding friendships difficult to keep? And what are the reasons people often put demands on friends? Those are some helpful insights as we learn how to build a quality biblical friendship. And I hope you're growing in your friendship to Jesus Christ, because he's the ultimate relationship we need to start with. So until next time, this has been your Maple Minute. Thanks for joining us. I'm gonna praise Jesus' name, because his love goes on forever. His love reaches to the highest mountain. His love stretches to the lowest valley.